I will never forget the last days of Erengard. The day the Purgatory came. The day our homeland was devoured by silence. The day everything turned to dust. The Crusade's onslaught was relentless. A war without end. My parents led our armies in a final, desperate charge against the invaders. The tide of battle soon turned against them. I should have been there, either to save them or to perish by their side. Only I remained to protect the survivors of our once mighty kingdom. But in my darkest hours, doubt took hold. How can I lead these people? Where to? Am I really worthy to be their queen? In my moment of despair, a golden light appeared from above. It was Isla. A holy celestial bird who had once guided my mother. I hear you, faithful guardian. Please show us the way.
Guided by Isla, Lorelei heads for the allied kingdom of Elbin. Her only hope is that Hauser, a loyal friend of her father and aid to Elbin's king, can grant her people sanctuary. At long last, the people of Erengard arrive at their destination, but something's amiss. Elbin's roads, fields, and villages are deserted. An ominous silence hangs thick in the air.
Look, everyone! Isla has found Elbin's capital. If we make haste, we could be there on the morrow.
Halt! State your name and kingdom!
I'm Princess... Queen Lorelei of Erengard. We seek an audience with King Atron.
You're an ally of Elbin, then! Which makes you our enemy!
Thank you.
Elbin, at war with Friedland. Our situation is even more desperate. I have to hurry. The capital might be in danger.
Lorelei rides with all haste through Silberstein's crowded streets, headed for King Atron's throne room. Her old friend Hauser lowers his mirrored mask and greets Lorelei with a warm yet weary smile. Elbin's monarch is nowhere to be seen.
Milady, it's good to see you. Though the skies over Elbin grow dark. What brings you here?
I need your help, old man. A purgatory has consumed Arengard.
Gods help us. This is grave news indeed. And your parents, your highness?
I'm queen now.
I'm so sorry. I'm sure King Atran will grant you sanctuary. But first, we need to rescue him from Doran's citadel to the north.
My people are tired, old man, but if we must.
Thank you, milady. We need to break the siege before the citadel's defenses are breached. At your command. I'm sorry about your parents. I should have been there.
I'm glad you weren't. You would have only shared my father's fate.
You must be cautious, m'lady. We can't afford to lose your bloodline. Please hurry, m'lady.
We have to break this siege before it's too late.
I am forever in your debt, but alas, I must request your assistance one more time.
I'm not here to fight. All I want is a new home for my people.
The Friedland capital can be that home. Just help me end this war.
Then I will oblige, but only for the sake of House Arengard.
Hauser, Queen Lorelei will need your support. Go! Attack Sternsicht at once!
At your command.
Friedland must live!
A once proud city Many years of conflict have taken their toll on Friedland's capital, Sternsicht. From atop a crumbling battlement, their aging matriarch, Raduin, surveys her kingdom's war efforts.
What's on your mind, m'lady?
You've lived this war for years, haven't you? I'm sure there's much to learn.
No doubt about it. I'll elaborate later. Here's your first lesson about this war. Once, Friedland and Elbin were allies. But then, four generations ago, Friedland's eastern lands were consumed by silence. So people began migrating west. Food was short, and tempers even shorter. The silence devoured Friedland, bit by bit.
And where silence falls, war is never far behind.
Indeed, m'lady. Our prospects are grim. I used to think the gods had a plan. Now I'm not so sure. These are desperate times.
Hey! Over here!
On the edge of Grunau Forest, a boisterous kobold is waving his wooden sword with reckless abandon. His eyes bulging with imagined riches, the little scamp turns around to greet his visitors.
Hey there! I'm Pip. Adventurer extraordinaire. At least, that's what I'd like to be. One day. But first, I need to prove myself. Keep this on the down low, okay? I'm on a top-secret quest for the mythical Singing Stone. I really hope I'm up to the challenge. You think I can do it, don't you?
Of course you can. I'm rooting for you.
Great. I really appreciate the help. We'll start in Grunau Forest. See you there. quite a battle, huh? I'm exhausted. I only wish there'd been some spoils, too. Our adventure is far from over. See you again. Toodle pip!
I remember the old King of Elbin from when I was little. He was a kind man. A good man. Just like father.
His wisdom is sorely missed these days, m'lady.
Are you all right, old man? You look worried.
I am fine, m'lady. I just have a lot on my mind lately.
Is spreading faster and faster. Now that the Crusade controls purgatories, it'll only get worse.
Thank you.
You haven't told me much about your new liege, Hauser.
King Atron has never known peace. He is not like you. I tried to be his conscience with all my might. But sometimes...
I'm sure he appreciates it. Father always did.
There's something I need you to know. Something about the king. No. I cannot.
Whatever troubles you, old man, it can wait. Tell me whenever you are ready.
Thank you, m'lady. you feel lost, m'lady, just look upwards. The guiding star watches our every move.
Who's come begging for mercy? King Atron's loyal cur.
You are the one who started this war, but I'll have no qualms ending it once and for all.
We are fighting for our survival. You, of all people, should understand. I have heard tales of your valor. We share the same plight. But unlike you, I have the guts to do the right thing.
King Atron and I seem to have a lot in common.
Less than you think, m'lady. Less than you think. Enough of your cruelty. You pillaged our farms, razed our cities to the ground.
We only did as we were done by, you sanctimonious fool.
Thank you.
Wake up, Queen Lorelei. King Atron's been playing you like a fiddle.
Don't listen to her, m'lady. She seeks to divide us.
I've loved Elbin ever since Father took me here. I was so young back then. Almost feels like another life. This is it. The silence. The same blight that devoured my home.
This isn't personal. Without fighting back, we'll perish.
I have seen many places like Friedland. Silence begets madness. It's always the same story. Why? Just why am I fighting King Atrin's war? No, I mustn't falter. Too many rely on me.
Thank you. Elbin invaders ahead!
I wish I could have met your father once more during this life, if only to tell him how proud he'd be of his daughter.
They look terrified.
Indeed, my lady. The silence has pushed them over the edge.
No, we have.
Thank you.
With Matriarch Raduin defeated, Friedland's remaining forces rapidly surrender. As the people of Erengard settle into their new home, Lorelei dispatches Hauser to brief King Atron. If Elbin stays true to her promise, both royal houses will sign a treaty of friendship before the next dawn.
We did it. Elbin's at peace once more.
I pray you're right, m'lady. Guiding Star, forgive me.
Finally, a new hope for peace. We shouldn't waste this opportunity.
Elbin reigns supreme!
What's wrong, old man?
I begged King Atron to honor his promise, but he's lost his mind. The paranoid fool cannot be reasoned with.
You knew of this, didn't you?
You must flee. He marches this way as we speak.
And then what? There's nowhere left to go. Isla? You cannot be suggesting what I think you are.
By the gods, not the silence. Anywhere but that forsaken place, m'lady.
Isla's right. This betrayal leaves us with no choice. Staying in Elbin means certain death. Whatever horrors await us in here, we must stay strong.
We'll be right back.
Thus, the first chapter of Lorelei's journey draws to a close. Unbroken by Atrin's betrayal, she follows Isla towards an uncertain future. The young queen sits straight in her saddle, but she cannot ignore the wide-eyed glances and hushed whispering as she leads her people deeper into the silence. She can only offer a quiet prayer that she's made the right decisions.